Hey, it's Priyanka. So far, we've looked at how Critter Junction launched and globally scaled an app on Compute Engine. Today, let's learn how they can make their social Critter app more scalable by gracefully replacing failed instances. With their growing daily active users, we helped them set up auto-scaling and global load balancing to handle globally distributed and constantly rising traffic. But to keep their users from risking their daily game streaks, they need to make sure their app is available all the time without interruptions. So today, let's focus on helping them set up high availability, or HA. We know that managed instance groups provide features such as auto-scaling, regional multiple zone deployments, auto-healing, and auto-updating. We covered the auto-scaling and regional deployments in the last episode, so check it out to learn more about global scaling. Today, let's focus on auto-healing and auto-updates. Auto-healing helps proactively identify and replace the unhealthy instances, the ones that are not responding, with the healthy ones. And the auto-update feature helps update the instances without disrupting the service. Let's focus on auto-healing for a bit. First, we create a health check, which not only detects whether the machine is running or not, but also detects application-specific issues such as freezing, crashing, or overloading. If an instance is deemed unhealthy, new instances are created by the managed instance group. Let's see how auto-healing works in action. In Google Cloud Console, I have the project from the previous episode opened here. First, we will create a health check in Compute Engine. Give it a name, protocol is HTTP, and let's say the path is /health. It can be any path you decide for your health check. In our demo app, we added code that ensures that /health returns a 200 OK response when healthy and HTTP 500 internal server error when unhealthy. Now for setting up health criteria, set check interval to 10, which means every 10 seconds, the service will be probed for health. Set timeout to 5, which means we wait for maximum 5 seconds for a response to a probe. Set a healthy threshold to 2, which defines the number of sequential probes that must succeed for the instance to be considered healthy. And finally, set an unhealthy threshold to 3, which defines the number of sequential probes that must fail for the instance to be considered unhealthy. And then create. As a best practice, you want the health check to be conservative so you don't preemptively delete and recreate instances. Now, let's go to our instance group we created in the last episode and add a health check to it. Select the health check with an initial delay of 90 seconds. Ideally, this initial delay should be long enough for the instance to be fully running and ready to respond as healthy. Let's have some fun with this and simulate failures now. For that, we go to the VM instance and click on external IP and make it unhealthy. Wait for the auto healer to take action and we will see that the green check mark next to the instance turns into a spinner, indicating that the auto healer has started rebooting that instance. One of the other concerns when it comes to HA is applying updates to the instances without impacting the service. Managed instance groups allow you to control the speed and scope of the update rollout to minimize disruptions to your applications. You can also perform partial rollouts, which allows for canary testing. Let's see that in action now. On our instance group, we see this rolling update button. Click on that. Word rolling means it is for gradual updates. We will add a second template for canary testing and select target size as 20%. This means we want to send 20% of the traffic to the new instances for canary testing. Now, update mode is by default proactive, which means Compute Engine actively schedules actions to apply the requested updates to instances as necessary. In many cases, this often means deleting and recreating instances proactively. You can choose to perform an opportunistic update if a proactive update is potentially too disruptive. An opportunistic update is only applied when you manually initiate the update on selected instances or when new instances are created by the managed instance group. Max surge means how many more instances are you willing to spin up as a part of this update. The higher value here speeds up the update but costs more for the new instances. So it is a trade-off between cost and speed. max unavailable, and min wait time. I will keep them as zero, but these parameters are used to control how disruptive the update is to your service and to control the rate at which the update is deployed. Through our help setting up two high availability features within managed instance groups, Courier Junction has a much more resilient architecture now. Auto-healing proactively identifies unhealthy instances and heals them, and auto-update updates instances without disrupting the service. Stay tuned to find out what more is in store for Critter Junction. And remember, always be architecting.